This time I'm going to show you a really important video about pulling fire alarms. I just put it to the title of bloopers. So if you walk up to one of these in a building, like if it's like anywhere, so and you just pull it. You think it's just a prank and you're just doing it. It's not funny. And everybody's going to be thinking there's a fire in the building. And then everybody's going to be evacuating. And then if you get fined, you're going to have to pay a fine, like a money fine. And then let's say you do it again, twice. Well, and you also get in a lot of trouble. So let's do it again. And they'll probably know it's you, so they'll probably try to find you again. And you're probably going to have to go to jail, so don't pull firearms at all. That's what stoppers are made for. For pulling firearms on purpose. What they're meant for is fire emergencies. So, if there's a fire emergency, you're okay to pull it. So if you're a firearm inspector and you're testing the firearm system, you're okay to pull it too. But if you're doing it on purpose and it's not an emergency, that is not okay. It's illegal to pull a firearm that's not an emergency. So, and it like firearms gonna come and it's just, you know, create a lot of chaos when it's not even an emergency. So, and that's called a false alarm. So, it'll be a false alarm. Yeah. And then, if you see one of these at your school or at like the store, or like at your hotel, or like at your work. If you live in an apartment building, they have these too. They're not as small. Those have smoke bombs. Hey, you know, don't pull it if you see one. Don't pull it or church or any building, a public building that has firearms like this. Don't pull this if you actually smell or see fire. That's my video. I'm not done yet, but it makes me really angry, and other people, other fire enthusiasts too, so, and probably all of them. And that's my video, why you should not pull firearms unless there's a fire, an emergency. Thanks for watching, and goodbye, like, subscribe, share.